Crash Bandicoot 2, 4? Have I been calling this 2 in the last videos? I hope not, but anyway, Crash 4. Walk through, and we are in another normal level, if you want to call it that. And this time we're playing as Crash, not as a side character, so that's kind of nice. Luckily, they don't make you play as side characters too often. She's out of breath for some reason. I almost died there. They do make you play as them later in the game. There's a world where you'll swap between them all again, but for now, it's really largely choice. So after you unlock the first level as a side character, then a whole bunch of other levels unlock as that side character as you go through the game. So that's kind of cool if you really like playing as one of them. I don't really care too much, but it is also unnecessary for the game. Just for my own sanity, in a strange way, I'm going to be playing through those side character levels after I beat the game, the so-called main game with Crash and Coco, and you could just as well do them normally. I mean, it really wouldn't affect anything, so I guess that's kind of up to you, but I will have videos of those later on. For now, though, we are going to continue on here with Crash and just trying to avoid all these anchor pendulums and the spiking, spinning rolling pins here. So if you are trying to go for all boxes, which I'm kind of in vainly attempting to do here, then it's a good idea to get as many boxes as you can before you hit the checkpoint, just because if you die, you don't have to waste time getting them all over again. So in the other Crash games, my least favorite parts of those games were the stupid vehicle parts, and the other ones you'd have like the jet skis or having to ride, what's his name? Oh, I did die once here, so I don't think I get that. Nope. You had to ride like the polar bear or the pig. I did not like those levels very much. I still don't like them in this game. So we get a really brief introduction to those right there. And then we have this checkpoint that took me about 16 tries to actually hit. And then we go back here to technically a vehicle part. We're kind of in the swamp and we're gonna have to jump past all of these spinning posts here with all the spikes on them. And also now we have to jump onto these rafts. I guess they're rafts, not really vehicles, but they're moving for you. So that's technically a vehicle in the video game world. So the tricky part here is that, like, right there you're gonna have to slide underneath those boxes, and it's kinda here is where I died a bunch of times. There's gonna be more boxes you're gonna have to slide under, and again, since I'm trying to go for all the boxes, make sure you don't hit the nitros. You gotta hit those ones, and then I would have to actually hit that exclamation box, which I did not manage to do because I think I gave up on hitting all the boxes in this level. And this thing is just going by so fast. I mean, watching the video doesn't look as fast as it feels. It's really weird. And then I tried to jump on that box, didn't make it. I was already missing them, so I didn't really... I was already missing a box, so I didn't really care too much. So I was like, yeah, whatever. Not gonna go back to try and destroy that one. I think you can jump back on rafts that are coming behind you there. But for the most part, that was a pretty tricky part of the... of this level, and it probably didn't look as bad as I am, like, having PTSD from, just because when you edit it in these videos, it looks a lot cleaner than it was. And then we have yet another motorboat section, which is gonna get pretty annoying later on. So we're briefly gonna have to jump back into this mask, the one that will allow us to warp things in and out of existence, so just kind of move them around as you can. Right here, if you notice boxes in this game that are arrow boxes, that are jump ones, and there's nothing above them, there's probably something above them, so just keep that in mind. And we can kind of warp this into reality to unlock these other boxes here. We do get the tiki guy to help us out in case we're taking damage, so that is kind of nice. You do want to try to kill the enemies before you go for boxes, you know, you just don't want to have to worry about that if you don't have to. And this part's kind of weird. You do sort of need to time that with that pendulum there so you don't get hit by the pendulum when you jump on the platform. And we're gonna have to do that again coming up here, which I think is where I died on this part a bunch. Kind of, honestly, this was a really hard level for this stage in the game. I think this was probably one of the hardest levels so far. Later on, this becomes extremely easy, and you're gonna wish they were all like this, but for now, this is just giving you a good taste of what you have to look out for. So those pendulums do go across the platforms. You do not miss them like I once thought, just keep that in mind. And once we get to the checkpoint, we have to go through this stupid last motorboat, and controlling this thing is a pain in the neck. It really does not go where you want it to, and it drifts all the time, and it's just, I don't know why games with water levels have to make them annoying. You know, they just have to be annoying. And there's also going to be these enemies that are on, like, these bombs that are going to be charging you, or at least they're on barrels. And you're going to want to try to get them to charge you in the direction of a bomb, one of those spike bombs. Otherwise, you'll have to kind of go back and try to circle around so they don't hit you. And if you have a tiki, you're probably going to lose it to one of those guys. And I think right here is where I had the hardest time. I just have no idea how I'm supposed to... Okay, I got past that guy. I don't know how I'm supposed to get past that guy and that bomb on the left side. So I just powered through it. But other than that, I don't know how you're supposed to do that perfectly. Maybe be way more patient. Either way, we get a little mini boss here. This is going to be some kind of swamp monster. And what we were doing before, we're going to have to do here. These enemies are going to be coming out on these barrels, which are explosive, and they need to run into the tentacles. You have to do this 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 times, and it has to be done in one life. So have fun with that. The rest of it's pretty straightforward, and that'll be it for this level.
I was at a 10 before, now I'm at a solid, let's say, 9.78888. Oh yeah, these bandicoots are here to help.
Bandicoot. Follow.
Short and to the point. Love this guy.